of your perspectives, but the yelling and the emotions, how do we take all of this frustration and the anger and this energy? This is the same question I asked Charles Barkley, and I would love to ask all three of you all, how do we move this forward?
Well, we need to have another discussion
if you want to understand the emotion.
Go ahead, boys.
Exactly.
You have to
be honest. And if you want to understand the anger and the outrage that I'm seeing everywhere, imagine how Americans felt right after 9/11. Think about this. If somebody's killing your children, what parent, what human being is not going to react emotionally when they know they can't send their child to the store for Skittles and iced tea without some possibility that they're going to come back dead? That is a very serious reality for so many black families in America. So, I would say this, that good cops that are out there, they want to deal with this problem as much as the rest of us do, because we don't want to live in a society where everyone's afraid of the police, where everyone hates the police, where black kids grow up thinking the police are all bad. But if you don't deal with this, if you continue to turn a blind eye to all these homicides, then you're going to have what actually could become a race war on your hands. We've got to be very, very careful.
Well, part of that is because people are trying to say that the majority of police officers, white police officers, are going out here with a target on young black men. That is just not the case. That is not the case. Are there bad officers? Is there police brutality? Yes, that happens, but that is not the majority of the case. The majority of police officers are good people who protect and serve with honor in this country.
So that's kind of
what I think that we should continue to cast aspersions on police officers as if there's some kind of brutal force that they wake up every day saying, how am I going to target black people? That is just not the case, and that discussion, that part of it, is not helpful.
That is part of what Charles Barkley was saying to me over and over and over when we were talking yesterday. Is a lot of police officer friends, black, white, and I think one of his points was he was frustrated because a lot of people are very critical of words that he's had a lot, especially when he sat down and talked to me, and he was saying, why can't we among the African American community agree to disagree? He was saying to me, why are people, throwing out words like Uncle Tom, calling him Uncle Tom, telling him he's a sellout, telling him he's a traitor, instead of just agreeing to disagree?
Well, Brooke, I think one of the things that you have to recognize here is this really is a matter of life and death. And so you have these high emotions that you reference because people are forgetting to take this all the way back to the most basic principle, and that is common humanity. I don't know how anyone can watch that Eric Garner video and not hear him say over and over again, I can't breathe. Right. I can't breathe.
I can't breathe.
Like, just think about the fact that this is somebody's father. That is somebody's son. And just because he looks a little bit different than you, and he might be a little bit bigger, that does not give you the right to take his life. It doesn't.
I don't think anybody's advocating that. I think anyone who looks at this video sees this as a tragedy. But we also have to realize it did not happen in a vacuum. We were not the grand jurors. We were not in that room. We did not. There doesn't rise
it's
to
not
level
in a
criminality.
Vacuum, it's pattern
no, it
in
was
practice,
not.
And that's
it
why
is,
it's a problem that has to be addressed.
And that's why we have a criminal justice system and a grand jury system.
That is
and why we have laws.
It's broken.
Well, we can have that discussion, but I don't know
and
that it's racially that it's based on race or based. It's not, look, again, there were 23 people on that grand jury who heard evidence and testimony and had a criminality level that we are not sitting here and having to do that. We're having an emotional discussion. They had the process. They were in the jury room. It did not rise to criminality. Perhaps maybe they can pass a law that makes that show hold illegal. But right now, it's not, and it did not rise to level of criminality. Should they discipline that officer? Probably yes. Should he be fired? Probably. It looked like excessive force to me. But he was resisting arrest. So we also have to look at situations where your own personal behavior and decisions
I don't think you can really say that Eric Garner was really resisting arrest.
Final thought, boys.
I'm not saying he deserved to die, but there was a resistance. Go ahead, boys. Go ahead.
Eric Garner threw his hands up in surrender, and he kept saying, I can't breathe, I can't breathe. I think that what you really saw was what consistently happens, where a big black man, just by his mere existence, is seen as some sort of threat. And it really goes back throughout history. Black men have always been seen as these big, scary, barbaric animals that don't feel pain, that need to be put down when they get out of line. And so, really, when you look at the criminal justice system, anybody who says that our system is not incredibly racist, racially biased is out of their mind. They need to go read the thousands of academic studies that have shown that black men are more likely to be stopped and frisked. They're more likely to be arrested. They're more likely to be convicted. They receive longer sentences when they go to prison. So the reality is that Eric Garner's experience resonates with millions of people because millions of people have either gone through it or they have relatives who've gone through it, and many of them have relatives who are in prison right now for things they did not do. That's a reality. We got to deal with that.
All right. On that note, I appreciate every single one of you. Boyce Watkins, Angela Rye, Tara Settmeyer. Thank you all very, very much. Coming up next, we're going to